do. You have to excuse my cough.
That's a mess.
But that cough and it's sweet cough because it's coming from the Lord.
Amen.
All of those things is good. Dear God, this is the day that you have made. We are so very thankful for it. Because you give us a new day to begin a new life. New beginning. New praise. New thanks, oh God, all that we have received this morning. May our works in you be acceptable. May our joys spread to one another. Let us all walk together as one in Christ. Let us be blessed, because blessing is ours. So saith the Lord. His grace is the mercy that we need in our lives. His love surrenders us to one another. And his peace divine extend us together as one to hold hands, to lift up hearts, to be thankful for what we are and what we can do, not what we can't do, because those things are gone and new things has begun in our life. So Lord, thank you for the life that we have. Thank you for the blessing that you have poured upon us. Thank you for this blessed day, especially. You gave us another day to see, another day to praise you, another day to give ourselves to you, another day to say, yes, Lord, here I am. Use me until you use me. Give praise to our Father, to our souls, to our hearts. So as we reach out, let us reach out to love. Let there be peace. Let there be humble hearts, a lifting soul, and a gladness that should always stir us up to wake up those that are sleeping and bring forth that crown of jewels from you in the name of Jesus. Bless this blessed day and let peace begin with us and from each one of us. Let us extend peace out to those we meet along the way. Bless this day in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. My responsive reading will come from Psalm 107. I read the light. Congregation, read the dog. Oh, give thanks to God, for God is good. For God's steadfast love endures forever.
Let the redeemed of God say so. Those whom God redeemed from trouble and gathered in from the land, from the east and the west, from the north and the south.
Some wandered in desert waste, finding no way to an inhabited town. Hungry and thirsty, their soul fainted within them.
Then they cried to God in their trouble, and God delivered them from their distress.
God led them by a straight way until they reached an inhabited town.
God turned the rivers into a desert and springs of water.
God turns a fruitful land into a salty waste because of the wickedness of its inhabitants.
God turns the desert into pools of water, a parched land into springs of water.
And we all say,
and then God lets the homies live, and they establish the town to live in. They sow fields and plant vineyards.
I'm gonna make it.
we did the history of the church with pictures and whatnot when we got together when I was here last time. So I just want to say I've had a love affair with purple for over 40 years.
Yeah.
I wore purple so much till I started to bore myself. So I had to cut it loose for a little while, but you know, I really love the color. And so that brings me to the book, The Color Purple, written by Alice Walker. How many of you have seen the Steven Spielberg documentary that's been on this last month? Yeah, Steven Spielberg directed that movie, among many other classics that most of us have seen. And he pointed out that there were a couple of scenes in the book that he chose not to include. First of all, there was controversy about him directing the movie at all. You know, they wanted a black man such as John Singleton or Spike Lee or somebody else to direct it. But, you know, Spielberg is a master director, and, you know, I think Alice chose him. And so he said, you know, she went so far in the book, particularly in the scene with Whoopi Goldberg, who was starving for love. And what is the name of this actress? I forgot her name right now. But they had a love scene. And, you know, he went into a lot of detail. Alice Walker went into a lot of detail, which she did not include in the movie. Anyway, that book has been made into a play twice. I went to see it when Fantasia was in it, because she's a fabulous singer. And of course, Jennifer Hudson was in it. You saw that one? Yeah, I figured that was enough already. I saw the movie, I read the book. When the book was out, I couldn't put it down. And so, The Color Purple. Then, Purple Haze. How many of you are familiar with Jimi Hendrix? Oh my God. Okay, let me just read some of the lyrics from that song. Purple haze all in my brain. Lately things they don't seem the same. Acting funny, but I don't know why. Excuse me while I kiss the sky. Now, there's some speculation about the state of his mind when he wrote those lyrics.
No.
Jimmy was out there, of course, and unfortunately, his drug abuse later took his life. But I'm sure many of you have seen his rendition of the Star Spangled Banner that he shared at Woodstock. And, I mean, it was just haunting. It was amazing. Last but not least, Prince. I still get really upset when I start to think about the death of one of my favorite musicians. Of course, he won the Oscar for his music in Purple Rain, the movie. And what else do I want to say about him? I mean, he also was out there, of course, but, I don't know if I should share this in church, but when he was on the Johnny Carson show, or was it Jerry, he performed, and then he turned around, and the back of his pants were cut out. My husband and I were watching this, and Brad just had a fit. Oh, my God. No, he didn't get on national TV. To that, but you know, and then he had the nerve to say at one of the BET awards that, you know, I think he was telling Beyonce that she should learn music. And then he was saying, you know, I was pretty wild as a youngster, but you all have to do what I do.
Right.
You know, he was a trip. Anyway, great musician. Purple.